Hello again, and welcome to Lecture 7, Select Data and Create a Quick Chart with Various Ways. So, the first step to create a chart is selecting the data. It's better to not include totals for now and put all the data together. After selecting data, we press Alt plus F1. It's the quickest way to create a default chart. The default chart in Excel is clustered column chart. Press Ctrl plus Z to undo. Another method is simply click on a cell of our data and press again Alt plus F1. Excel is smart enough to select all the data of the table, as you see. But with this method, Excel includes all the columns like totals in our table or if we have averages, etc. So be careful and do again. If we want to select non-adjusted areas, for example the first column with programs and the column with totals, then we will use the Control key. We select these cells, press Control and select totals. Again, Alt F1, and chart is ready with the selected columns. Until now, we created a chart in the same worksheet with our data. But sometimes it's better to have a chart in a new worksheet. This method is simple. We highlight the cells of our data with mouse, and then we press F11 key. A chart will appear on a new worksheet called Chart 1, as you see. It shows only the chart with no distraction from our data. Of course, by making changes to the values of data, the chart will be changing, even though it is in a different worksheet. Let's see it in practice. Go to Data Worksheet, change cell B3, type 500, enter, go to chart 1 and see the difference. Press undo from this button now. When we select data in the lower right corner, a quick analysis tool pops up. It has 5 different tab settings, like formatting, charts, totals, tables, and sparklines. Most of these new features we will show as we continue to the course. We can, for example, create a chart easy. Like this. Pretty fast method. If default chart isn't that we want, then after selecting data, we click Insert tab from the ribbon. And we see a number of choices relating to specific chart category. Each category of a chart has many choices, simply by clicking the arrow over the icon. Finally, Excel 2013 has a lovely new function, the recommended charts. It's again on the Insert tab and is ideally for new Excel users. With this method, Excel recommended us charts that think they will best fit with our data. If we don't like recommended charts, we can choose from All Charts tab. From this, the one that believe it's best for our data table. Thanks for watching and see you in the next lecture. Bye.